Hey there, it's James Francis. I hope you're well. I was just finishing up for the weekend when I received a question from one of our coaching clients, and it went something like this. James, why should somebody buy from me when all of my competitors are doing a much better job? Right? And that's an easy, easy mindset thing to fall into when you're just getting started with your online business. You look at your competitors' websites, they're perfect, and you're like, how can I compete with that, right? Maybe they have a few different product lines. Maybe their marketing is much better. They will obviously have better budgets than you. They obviously already have an audience when you don't, and so on and so on. And it's easy to fall into the trap of like, what's the point when my competitors are doing a much better job? Nobody's gonna buy from me. But here are some reasons why that is not true. So the first thing is that you have a personality. Whether you're an introvert like me or an extrovert, you will have some specific way of getting your approach across to others. Whether that's the way you speak, your accent, which is familiar to some people and not familiar to others, maybe the way that you teach things in a certain way that makes sense to some people but not others, and so on. We all, as experts, have these nuances about ourselves which differentiate us from our competition. For example, I know some people in my industry that have really annoying personalities, and you may be watching this video thinking that I have an annoying personality, but this will apply across your niche as well. Sometimes your prospects will prefer to listen to you over your competitors just because of the way you speak, the way you write things, and your general approach to teaching different concepts in your niche. The second thing is being in the right place at the right time. I know it's happened to me, but sometimes you have one of those days where something just gets to you and it's on your mind and you're browsing through Facebook and an ad appears about that thing. And naturally, because you're in that emotional mindset, you click it to figure out what it is and sometimes end up buying it, right? That's what's going to happen to your prospects. You may be advertising your stuff, whether it's Facebook ads or Google ads or whatever traffic source you're using, you would be advertising your solution to their problem, and because they are experiencing their problem right there in that moment when they're seeing your ad, it's like, why would they not go and click on that, right? It doesn't matter that your competitors are doing a better job, but because you've been there in the right moment, at the exact moment where they're struggling with that thing, it means they're going to take action right now with an impulse buy. And that brings me on nicely to the third thing, which is that they may not even know about your competitors. Especially if somebody is brand new to the industry, let's say I decided to take up underwater basket weaving tomorrow, I wouldn't have a clue who those competitors are. I wouldn't have as much knowledge about that industry as you would, being inside that industry as an expert or a business owner, because I haven't experienced it yet, right? So to them, your prospect, you are the competitor, you are the best because that's all they've encountered so far. Makes sense, right? And that brings me nicely onto the fourth thing, which is more about a marketing strategy. Now, this is all about not doing the same thing as your competitors in the form of a marketing hook, okay? You may have heard of marketing angles or hooks before, but essentially they're a way to differentiate what you're doing, what you're teaching, what you're selling to your competitors by, God forbid, actually being different. It's a unique strategy, right? If you don't want to be like your competitors, if you don't want to be compared to them, don't be like them. You can be different just by rewording certain things in your marketing. For example, instead of how to, let's say, train your dog, lose weight, improve your credit score, improve your arthritis or remove arthritis pain or something like that, as an example, going with the arthritis example as well, you could say something like how this truck driver found this unique ingredient which reduced his arthritis pain in 7 days or less. You know, something like that is much more compelling than just how to whatever the end result is. By adding in those unique parts to your hook, it's going to stand out instantly from your competitors, and that way you're not going to be compared to them because it's totally different. Cool, right? And that brings me nicely onto the fifth and final step I'm going to be sharing with you today, which is to have a unique methodology, okay? Those of you who have read my best-selling book, Ignition, will know all about this. But essentially, what it is think of your offer or whatever you're selling as having two separate layers of marketing, if that makes sense. The first layer is your marketing hook or angle, whatever you want to call it. And that is the overall concept of what you're selling, the thing that you're selling. And then we have the second layer, which is the process used to get to the end result, okay? So think of the first layer as like the overall result. The second layer is how do they get there, okay? So in terms of how do they get there, If you are doing exactly the same thing as your competitors, you're teaching the same methods, you're teaching the same strategies, of course, you're going to blend in with those people and you're not going to make any sales, especially if your competitors have bigger budgets than you. A way around this is to map out the process that you take people through to get to the end result that you're promising. For example, helping somebody to lose weight. What are the things they need to do specifically to lose that weight, to lose the amount of weight that you're promising or, you know, guaranteeing or whatever it is in your product. Now, when you have that mapped out, think of a name for that process, okay? So a good example is the ask method by Ryan Levesque, okay? So he could have just said, you know, how to ask your prospects or clients what they want to hear so you can give it to them. But that's not as compelling as naming that process the ask method. Same thing with my products, the prosperity formula. I could have just said how to build a six-figure online business. Not as compelling, it's been done to death. So instead, I named it the prosperity formula. So I would recommend naming this process or unique methodology as something like the something method, the something formula, the something process, whatever. It's totally up to you and your creativity, but when you name something after you, it becomes unique to you and your competitors cannot compete with that because it's completely different. It's not something that can be Googled. It's not something they can compare with a competitor because you will be the only person doing that thing. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video. If you have, go ahead and give it a thumbs up if you're watching on YouTube. If you are also on YouTube, go ahead and subscribe to make sure that you catch the future videos, and I will see you very, very soon. Have a great day. Bye-bye.